union of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today I welcome the recent graduates who are present among us, including the Wetzel Scholarship winner, whose name will be announced later at Mass. Also, I welcome Richard Cole and his family. Richard will be making his first communion. And in case I forget, if I may, because I tend to be absent-minded about some things, I will thank the choir because this is their last Mass before they take a break for the summer. They have worked many hours, they rehearse every week, plan the music, and so forth. I'm very grateful for all they have done. So, and Jim Slyke, the choir director, particularly, so that's the story. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The children may come forth, the children's liturgy be the word. From the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly, there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native tongue? We are Parthians, Medes, Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, live by the Spirit, and you will certainly not gratify the desire of the flesh. For the flesh has desires against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. These are opposed to each other, so that you may not do what you want. But if you are guided by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are obvious: immorality, impurity, lust, idolatry, sorcery, hatreds, rivalry, jealousy, outbursts of fury, acts of selfishness, dissensions, factions, occasions of envy, drinking bouts, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. In contrast, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such, there is no law. Now those who belong to Christ have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live in the Spirit, let us also follow the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please read the sequence along with me. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
And from this flesh so long, shed a ray of life divine. Come, Father of glory. Come, source of all our sorrow. Come within our bosom shine. You are comforter's best. You are the soul's most welcome guest. Seek refreshment here below. In our labor, rest most sweet. Grateful coolness in the heat. Solace in the midst of woe.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If someone were to ask you, what is the greatest gift that Jesus gave to the world, what would you say to them? I bet that if I asked 10 people that question, I would get some good answers, but maybe I wouldn't hear what I'm looking for, which is the greatest gift Jesus gave to us is the Holy Spirit. Who is the Holy Spirit? You know, the Holy Spirit is something like electricity. You can't see him, but you can tell that he exists because of his effects. As electricity, of course, powers lights and many other things. We live in a world that is full of these invisible realities. Gravity is another one. We know what gravity is, but we can't actually see it. Understand that bodies attract or are attracted to other bodies. And things fall. Every day we have to deal with gravity in some way, shape, or form. The Holy Spirit is God, third person of the Blessed Trinity. Now the question is, well, what effects come from this third person of the Blessed Trinity? Who is, you might say, a kind of energy. He is a person, to be sure. He instills life into people. Well, there are so many of them, but I'll just pick out a few. You can be grateful for that, I suppose. 2 weeks ago, at the Cathedral Church in Cleveland, which is called St. John's Cathedral, East 9th and Superior Avenue, 4 men were ordained for priesthood. Last Monday, I attended a function sponsored by the Knights of Columbus, in which 6 seminarians were honored and supported in their vocations. One of whom is our own Christopher Stein. Now, nationally, there are about 600 ordinations a year. That means about 12 per state. So Cleveland had 4. Youngstown Diocese, which is right down the street, is in Ashtabula County. That's where it begins, anyway. There's 1 man being ordained to priesthood this year. So the question is, why would anybody become a priest? And it's not a matter of saying, well, you know, these are fellows who couldn't find other career paths. You know, seriously. Or they couldn't find anybody to marry. So they decided to become priests. Well, if either of those two things is true, of any of those men, you can bet they'd be asked to leave the seminary. So what is it that draws a man into the life of the priesthood? The answer is he's impelled by the Holy Spirit to do it. The Holy Spirit, the person is open to the Holy Spirit, moves people in a certain direction, although without taking away their free will. So the young people in our lives need to be trained to be people of prayer in order to be open to the Holy Spirit, because everybody has some kind of a vocation. Without the Holy Spirit, we wouldn't have any priests, we wouldn't have missionaries, we wouldn't have any lay activists. Now, the church is primarily a lay organization. It's not primarily made up of priests, although you need priests, obviously. There'd be no Mass without priests, no Eucharist, and so forth. But 90% plus are lay people, which is as it should be. So what does the Holy Spirit do for the laity? Well, I can think of a man named Patrick Hogan. Patrick Hogan was a member of the parish where I was assigned, I suppose about 20 years ago. And at one point he came up to me and told me that he was distributing rosaries to the sick. He would go to a hospital and start distributing rosaries to the people. And nobody told him to do it. He didn't get a call from me or from anyone on the parish staff suggesting that he do this. However, it was a good thing he was doing. Why put a stop to something that is apparently of the Holy Spirit? It's impelling him to do this. So I worked with him and I suggested that he become involved in the parish's Legion of Mary, which is an organization consistent of lay people who do different tasks or ministries, visiting new parishioners, visiting the sick, distributing religious literature, maybe teaching religion, helping out at Mass, these kind of things. The list is very long of the things that they could do. But the Legion of Mary is designed to channel people's impulses to serve the needs of the church on a more active level. It opens people up to the graces of confirmation. So anybody who's confirmed in the Catholic faith has a special share in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit imputes us to the apostolate. The apostolate means active work in service of the mission of the church. Incidentally, Immaculate Conception will be starting a Legion of Mary organization. We will have an informational meeting a week from Tuesday night. We have, I think, 5 or 6 people so far. Think about it. Now, there may be people thinking, well, Father, you know, I have a family to raise. I'm holding down a couple of jobs. I have all kinds of responsibilities. I really can't get involved at that level. Well, is the Holy Spirit relevant in those cases? Yes. Because without the Holy Spirit, it's not possible to live the spiritual life. St. Paul tells us that the Holy Spirit works in us to put to death the misdeeds of the body. In other words, without the Holy Spirit, we can't possibly repent of our sins. We can't recognize Jesus as our Savior. We can't recognize the Father of God. We can't testify to the truth. We can't really live the faith. And if the Holy Spirit is not active, then it puts a damper on the way people's attitudes. So, in other words, a person might have faith, but it's kind of a dead faith. I go to church because I have to go. There's no real impulse there or desire. So faith without the Holy Spirit is hardly alive. We need the Holy Spirit because He gives us fruits. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, generosity, self-control. These are all issues that people have to deal with. People who live spiritual lives, what does it say, in the Holy Spirit, are people who are living a life that is full of fruits, fruitfulness. And it's really a down payment on the resurrected life. So when the resurrection time comes, and anybody who participates in the resurrection will be completely perfected in this human humanity. The beginning of that is here with life in the Spirit. So people need to pray. No prayer life, no Holy Spirit, no. People need to turn from their sins. People need to follow the teachings of the church. People need to do spiritual reading. People need to forgive other people. So there aren't any blockages to the Holy Spirit. I would also suggest praying to the Holy Spirit, asking for His gifts, acknowledging His existence, adoring Him. You can say, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Everybody knows that now. Come, Holy Ghost, fill the hearts of thy faithful, and kindle with them the fire of thy love. Beautiful prayer. It's a longer one than what I've just stated. And there are other things we can do. Don't forget the Holy Spirit. Finally, if the Scripture tells us the Holy Spirit is in us, then it's the Holy Spirit who will cause this mortal body of ours to rise from death, which should be of interest to everyone. Come, Holy Spirit, fill our hearts. Amen.
Not legalize any redefinition. that could corrupt what God had designed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community gathered by God, that the Spirit who makes holy our Eucharistic gifts may strengthen and refresh us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray especially for the sick. Wallace Kowalski, Rosemary Raymond, George Donnelly, Betty Dingle, Catherine Barish, Sandy Franklin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of the departed, that they may be more fresh in the life-giving spirit, especially Gregory Donald and Jerry Bird. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Also for Krista Barker, for whom the Mass is designated, today we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we are grateful for the opportunity to intercede on behalf of these important needs. Please hear our prayers and grant not so much what we want, but what we need. Through your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The second collection will be for the relief efforts after the earthquake in Nepal.
Our hymn for the preparation of the gifts can be found in your gather book, number 800.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you.
blessing of their way when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Lord Jesus. Before we close the Mass, I needed to recognize the Wetzel Award winner for 2015. Every year, for so many years, Mrs. Wetzel's estate has provided sum of money for a worthy graduate from high school to help pay for college. There are three judge panel, each of the eligible seniors is to write an essay. It's a blind thing, so I don't know who the people are and so forth. I'm not on the panel, so it's a clean operation, basically. So I'd like to award this year's Wetzel Scholarship to Mackenzie Mann. Tomorrow's Mass is at 9 o'clock. Let us pray. Oh God, if you so heavenly gift upon your church, safeguard me, pray the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual truth may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.